every web designer's cross to bear. Building websites for clients isn't just our job. It's a constant test of patience. It's kind of like a demanding golden retriever, forever seeking attention. And just when you think you've satisfied it, it's back for another belly rub. Now, in the design world, clients might not request belly rubs. At least, they shouldn't.
Hey there, it's good to hear from you. So, hey, I'm dreaming of some delicate animations, some vibrant gradients, and probably some snazzy text. I think that'll look real good on the website, eh? I should be able to play around with them and to kind of do whatever I want and make changes anytime, you know, any place. I should just be able to do that. No problem. That should be a piece of cake for you, eh?
Yes, sir.
All right. Catch you later.
Sounds like a bit of a nightmare, doesn't it? It doesn't have to be that way. There's a new hero in this digital world, a space where your creativity flows unhindered by coding and client constraints.
Wait.
Welcome to
Who are you?
Easy there. I'm just your voiceover guy, chronicling your tale of design salvation. May I continue, please?
Okay.
Okay. Welcome to Wix Studio.
Wix Studio just released, and I've been deep into learning all about the new platform and its brand new features. Hey, my name's Brad Hussey, and if you've been looking for a no-code solution to build beautiful, responsive, and unique websites to meet your clients' needs, smash deadlines, or work on your next project, well, I've got you covered with today's video. Let's not waste any more time, and we'll jump straight into it. You know, Wix Studio lets you create some pretty amazing stuff without having to dive into code. But the real magic? They're code-free animations. See this animation on the screen right now? Smooth as butter, isn't it? Well, that's all Wix Studio, baby. Stay with me and I'll show you how to sprinkle your site with that sweet digital deliciousness. So why don't we start off with something real simple. I'll just edit the site. So I'm gonna select this text element, which is kind of like our hero text element, open up my inspector panel. And now in our interactions tab, we have everything from entrance to hover, click, scroll, and loop animations. And each of these have lots of different customization options and presets that we can use. So what we're gonna do is select this inner interactions. I'm gonna add an entrance animation, and you could choose any of these, any animation that you want. But you know, I'm just gonna choose something like bloom. I mean, actually that looks kind of cool. Neat. I'm gonna adjust the animation though, and I'm gonna make the direction come from, you know, like 270 degrees. So that's directly from the left. Preview that. And maybe I want the distance to be further. So right now it's 20%. So that's probably relative to the size of the element. I'm gonna say 70%. So that's coming in from further off screen. Let's actually make it 100%. So it should just come from fully off screen in, it blooms in, perfect. So when I hover over each of these images, I want them to kind of grow in a real gentle way. So I'm gonna edit this. I'm gonna select the first element of this repeater. Now, if you've ever watched some of our videos on the different editor X functionalities and layouting options, one of them is a repeater, and repeaters will repeat the designed element. It will repeat the design across all the elements. So if I modify the layout and the design of this item in the repeater, the rest will follow suit. If I change the content, it won't change the content. This element right here in the repeater, I'm gonna drill down into the item, the image itself. Now in my inspector panel, switch over to the interactions, and I'm gonna select a hover interaction. Now, when you hover, it will trigger some sort of animation. So on hover, start the animation, and then we're gonna choose this as the animated element. You can choose other elements that are on in the repeater, like the button or the text, or you could select it on the canvas, but we just want to affect this image. So then what I'm gonna do is do it like a, let's do an expand. Okay. You can also do custom. You can create custom animations right here, and you can do all sorts of different things. You could choose a starting keyframe, an ending keyframe. You can move it around the canvas. You could change it. You could change its styles, its CSS, and that will be your custom animation. I'm gonna keep it simple here and just choose our preset animation to expand on hover. Now I can adjust this and I could say from its current position or into its current position, but I want it to expand from this position. I want to scale, let's go 108%, and we'll just check that out. Okay, now I want it to last longer, 1.5. Let's see what that looks like on hover now. Very cool. Even though you can do mostly anything you want without code in Wix Studio, sometimes you just need access to the code to further customize your work, whether it's tweaking global button colors, finessing typography across your entire site, or diving into custom CSS transforms and animations. Well, it's all at your fingertips. See this cool effect on the screen? Well, that's the magic of CSS right within Wix Studio. Ready to see how it's done? Fire up Wix Studio, switch to code view, and let's play. We've got a section, we've got an H1 that I'm calling outline, an image, and an H1 that I'm calling title, and then a level 6 heading as well. So that's how it's ordered in my layers panel. Now, you can't really see the two differences between these two H1s because, well, they're identical. So I have two H1s, and all I've done is I've used the same font and the same text, the same size, and just put it on top of one another. Now, here's where things get interesting. I have the top H1 called outline, and then I have an image which is next. So this image is actually in between these two elements, and that is key because now as I open up my code view, I can start playing with some CSS. So let me just first show you what's really cool is you can use CSS to modify your site using, you know, global styles. So for example, all buttons have the class of button. If I were to change the color of buttons, you can see that everywhere on this page, buttons have changed to the color that I've set in CSS, overriding whatever I've set in the design panel for buttons, as you can see here. So I'm gonna take the text outline class. Now this text outline class, as you see right here, is actually when I select the outline layer, so now it's selected on the canvas and go back to my code view, you can give any element a custom CSS class. And so I will give this the class of text-outline. Now that means I can just choose the text outline class in my code editor and start styling it the way I want. Now what I've done here is selected text outline and then a descendant selector and then asterisk. This just simply means select any child node within this text element. And in Wix Studio, a text element like what you see on the screen here may have some child nodes within it, like a span tag, for example. So I'm simply selecting and drilling down into this text element and choosing any child element. I'm making the color transparent, so it means no color of the text. And then I'm giving it a text stroke of 5 pixels and white. Now you can't see that. So let me just show you, prove to you that it is in fact there. So now you can see it, but because it's white on white, you couldn't see it before. But here's where it's gonna get really interesting because this image is in between the two elements in terms of its, how it's organized on the canvas. When I scroll, if that image goes in between the two, like for example, you're gonna see the top layer and it's gonna hide the bottom layer. So now you can see that outline effect. But to make this look really cool, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select both of these elements here. So let's start with the bottom layer and set its position to sticky and make sure it's 20% offset from the top. I'll do the same for the top outline H1, make sure it's sticky and 20% offset. And so now when I scroll on this page, that image will then go through those two layers, giving that interesting effect. Now I could leave it there and say that was a success with CSS, but we could do more. So I'm gonna select this image and go in my code view. And I'm gonna make sure I give it the class of hero-image. You can call it whatever you want, but I'm calling it hero-image. Because if I just select the default global image class, like so, in my code editor, I could choose image, and this will style all images on the site. I don't want to do that. Now, if you do, great, this is your class. But what I want is to use my custom class, hero-image, so that it will select only elements with this class. So what I'm gonna do now is transform the hero image to do something interesting like rotate it 5 degrees, give it an opacity of 80%, and blur it 5 pixels. I could do that with CSS. Now, when I scroll through, that's going to have another interesting effect. A cool visual kind of pattern disrupt that I'm doing exclusively with CSS in Wix Studio. In the design world of yesteryears, creating gradient backgrounds and text masks felt like rocket science for many. The intricate code required would often deter even the most seasoned designers. But fast forward to today, Wix Studio has turned that challenge into child's play. Now we can whip up custom gradients and craft SEO-friendly text masks filled with vibrant media like pictures, gradients, or videos without the coding hassle. All right, so let's create a background gradient. Let's try something real simple here. I'm gonna take this section and I'm gonna make it fit to the screen. I'm gonna make it larger, kind of like that. So it'll be the height of my viewport. And now the background, I'm gonna change in the color picker. I'm just gonna choose gradient. You can also choose mesh, like a fluid gradient, if you wanna change it up. So let's maybe try that, that's fun. And you can create custom gradients. You can save gradients like this. You can fully play around with your gradients. You can add new points on your gradients and choose new colors. And now what I wanna do is actually take this text, modify it a little bit. I'm gonna make it a little bit larger, and then I'm gonna add a text mask in the background. So this is cool. Under the add panel, I'm gonna go to text, and then down here you can go to text masks. And these are all a bunch of different options that you can play around with. So I'm gonna choose something like this top one here, explore. I'm just gonna drag it into the canvas, somewhere in the middle, and I can just adjust where it's sitting. Now I'm gonna change the text to say aqua. Now I want it to be a different font trend. That's kind of cool. And I'm just going to resize this. All right, so I've got my text mask here with an image, and that's cool, but I kind of want to change it to like videos. So I'm gonna go and make sure under my media, I'm gonna choose videos, and then maybe I'll type in water. And let's find a really cool, that's fun. I want this one to be the water playing behind my text mask. And then instead of a gradient back here, I'm actually gonna change this as well to have media, and I'm gonna choose videos, water as well. And I want this water to be my background. Nice, so now I'm gonna take this text mask, I'm gonna arrange it to move backwards. I can also use the keyboard shortcut Command Option Down. And that should move it back a layer. Perfect. And now let's preview that and see what we've come up with. That's really cool. Ever tried customizing your cursors and just ended up cursing? Well, Wix Studio's got the fix for the custom cursors, not your cursing. Turn any vector into sleek cursors in seconds. See that cool cursor effect? Well, I'll show you how to create it, adding flair and meaning to your site. All right, so I switched it up a little bit, and what I did was I created a couple cells, and I'm using a morning beauty routine and an evening beauty routine. And over here in our inspector panel, let me just open it up, you can go down to the cursor. And we're going to add an image or SVG. We can do custom ones. And I'm gonna use let's use a sun. So now I can do something fun like media from Wix. I'm gonna use the sun. I'm gonna make sure that it is vector art. And then I can choose like a real cute, cheesy sun like this one. And then for this one, I can use the moon. And let's have like something that kind of matches. There we go. Now, when I preview this, so now we've got our moon, our sun and our moon. Now, obviously, it's hard to see the sun, and the moon is maybe not big enough. So what I'm going to do is customize that. So I'm going to select the first one, and I can change the size to something like, I don't know, 128 pixels for that one. And for this one, let's make it a little bit bigger as well. Let's go 50 pixels. So now they kind of match in size, maybe 42 pixels. Now if I preview this, now we've got custom cursors when you hover over this, and a nice custom cursor when you hover over that. And you can change it to be whatever you want. You can design your custom SVGs, you can download SVGs, you can upload it for this. Have you ever felt like you're stuck in a design deja vu, crafting the same elements over and over and over? Wix Studio feels your pain. With their new platform, you can save those beautifully designed, spot-on user interfaces and components that you just nailed. And you can templatize them and turn them into templates, global assets, and even roll them into future projects. From entire site templates to individual color palettes and components, you build once and you could use it over and over again without having to reinvent the wheel. Let me show you how to say goodbye to repetitive work and hello to design efficiency. Let's go. So let's say I spent considerable amount of time designing a user interface or a component or an asset that I really liked, like this, for example. And I think, you know, I might want to reuse that on the site. Maybe I want to make that accessible on different pages or global across different pages. Or heck, maybe I want to be able to save this layout and use it on different websites or projects all together. Well, you'd normally what you'd have to do is like, you know, maybe just look at it in a different tab and try and copy it, try and remember how you did it or reinvent the wheel on every page. But obviously that's a waste of time and Wix Studio knows that. So you don't have to do that nonsense. So for example, I designed this section. I really like it. So what I want to do is I actually want to save it as an asset. So there's a couple ways I could do this. I could just right click on, you know, what I'm trying to save. Problem with that is you might accidentally right click on something like a cell and you don't want to save the cell as an asset, although I don't think you can anyway. You want to save the actual section as an asset. So you can either right click on the section in the padding area here, save as asset, but a more reliable and professional way of doing it is just go to your layers panel, find what you're trying to save. This section here, let's even call it something like product lineup or product trio. How about that? And then I can click the three dots and then just say save as asset. Now I can save this as a product trio. And what I can do is either add it to my saved assets. So that's just going to be in my general saved assets across my Wix Studio sites, or I can create a new library and call it something specific like beauty brand. And I can save that and use that as what I want to save it into. So I think I just saved it into my beauty brand. So if I go to my assets, I can go to the beauty brand and I can see that that product trio is saved there. So that's accessible as a library right here, or I could just save it into saved assets and it will just show up on in a general kind of bucket called saved assets. Now, another way of doing this is you can save this asset into your general saved assets. And then as you build up this bucket of saved assets, you can then go to more actions and do something like add assets to library. You know, you can take, reuse these assets on any site in your account, and you can throw it into one of these libraries or create a new library. So let's say, for example, I want to create another page. So I'm going to go to my pages, create a new page. I could do something as simple as going to my assets and say, all right, I need that product trio. I'm just going to drag it in there. And there it is. Perfect.
You don't need to know how to code to make websites anymore. And it doesn't have to take so long either. With Wix Studio, you can make a beautiful and responsive website fast, and you'll be able to meet any client's specifications with ease. Jump into the platform and start playing with it today. And if you're feeling a little stuck, well, you can join us in the Creative Crew. It's my free online community for professional designers and agency owners who want accountability, mentorship, and professional networking every single week. Next, why don't you check out this video of me building a one-page website in under 20 minutes using the new Wix Studio and utilizing all the new tools and features that we covered today. I'll see you over there.